Greetings, people. We are talking about Windows 10 end of life, and I made a lot of videos about these kind of subjects before, but new year, new videos. I'll probably make 2 videos or 10 videos about this. It's something that we need to fucking draw in and we need to talk about because a lot of people get this one. Windows 10 end of life is October this year. Everyone is going to move to Linux. Linux is taking over the world. Linux is going to be blah, 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 all that fucking shit. First of all, end of life don't really mean end of life. It's not like they are taking down Windows 10. You can never get it anymore. And if you are running Windows 10, your computer just automatically become a prick and you can't even boot into Windows anymore. There are people on this earth. There are companies using Windows from the 90s. We got some computers to prove that at work at some point where operatitions, so what the I thing is, we got a computer in that was used, I think, like last year or something like that, that was used up till last year, that ran Windows 98 or something like that, or XP, I can't remember, one of those two systems. That was last year. So what does end of life mean for the consumer? Nothing. And all it is, will remain in support with monthly security updates. That's what actually really matters, security updates. You are losing out on features and stuff like that. So added features. Sometimes they will backport it. But most of the times you're losing out on features. But as long as you're secure and you're okay with the features you have, I can't use DirectX 15 or whatever at that point or what it's called. Or there are some software that won't work. I think was it Valve that stopped supporting Windows 7 or something like that. At some point that will happen. Because they're using new technologies that are only supported by new versions of Windows. But for 99% of people, this is not going to be an issue. They don't fucking care. There are still people buying Android phones with an outdated OS, like an outdated version of Android, that don't even fucking get security updates and using it for years and years and years. Or they bought, like this one here still gets security update, but this is an S21. It don't get new. I think 14 is the latest Android version. This is stuck on. But it still gets security updates for like 2 more years or 1 more year. And after that, it don't. I can still use it. I can probably still, you know, install software on it from the App Store for at least like 4 more years, something like that. And people do that all the fucking time. This is not a big issue. Companies will pay Microsoft for extended support. That's what they do with XP. That's what they do with all the other versions of Windows that are heavily used in the corporate world. And Windows 10 is super heavily used in the corporate world. Your computer don't. It's not like on October the 14th, you go to work October the 15th, and there's a big fucking screen when you boot up into your Windows 10 machine that says, "Ha, loser! end of life, can't use it anymore." They will not notice one fucking thing at all. And here's another thing you have to also think about is that there are so many ways of getting the ISOs. Let's say there's the retro community installing Windows XP, Windows 7, even Windows fucking 8 if they are really, really crazy. You know, or Vista. There are plenty of ways of getting old ISOs. It's not like you can't get it and install it. If you really, really wanted to, it's probably not going to work, but you probably have to tweak it a little bit, but you can go and download Windows 95 today and install it on your fucking modern machine. If you, again, you probably need some specific hardware and so on and so on. And the sun is really weird today. It's cloudy and then not cloudy. It's not like Microsoft take it out of their... Do they still have... It's not like Windows just disappear from the fucking ether of the internet. Nothing disappear on the internet. That's another thing. You know, like every time, and this is on the fucking dot, every time there is a new end-of-life release of Windows, the collective Linux YouTube community go into a twist and make, not hundreds, but make tens of videos about everyone is going to use Linux, this is the time, blah, 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 the Microsoft is bad, blah, 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 this is where Linux is going to shine, blah, 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 and nothing happens. It's like every fucking year since 2000 is the year of the Linux desktop. This year, Linux is taking over the desktop. 2001. This year, Linux is taking over the desktop. 2025. This year, Linux is taking over the desktop. and then you go look at the market share. Oh, it's under 4% now. Oh, it's a little bit over 4%. Where's like Linux taking over the desktop? And then you see again the collective Linux YouTube community sniffing the good old copium and finding ways of, yeah, but they really did it because they grew like 0.1% or there were a few companies adopting it, or they find ways of justifying it. Right? Oh, maybe the end of life of Windows 7 did not do it, but it at least opened the eyes for a few more users, and some forums got an uptick in Linux activity for a while. You know, the copium is flowing good and wide and strong. This means nothing for Linux. There's still a lot of people will either migrate or stay with Windows 10. They don't give a fuck. They really don't give a fuck. The fact that the Linux community can't see that, being the highly educated and highly technical people that they say they are, is super baffling to me. It's on the keen of like seeing a monkey throwing shit at a wall and then be surprised that they do it the next day. They're still throwing shit? I thought they'd stop doing that. They evolved since yesterday. No, it's a monkey. It will throw shit at the fucking wall. If Linux wants to take over the desktop, they don't need Microsoft to not succeed, because then they're not good enough. Linux should be taking over the desktop while Microsoft is at their best, while Apple is at their best. But the Linux, this is how the Linux community think. It's like you are, let's just say you're doing the 100 meter sprint. You're always the third guy or girl. Instead of working harder, instead of getting better trainers, you are like, we need to break the legs of number one and two, because then I will be the third. I will be number one. This is how the Linux community and the Linux YouTubers think. They are waiting for Apple and Windows to fail, because then Linux will automatically succeed. What the fuck is that? That will never happen. At least not like in the near future. And thinking like that, this like, okay, the best and second best OS for the most people is not here anymore. So now they are forced to use the crappy third. Because that's how the world look at Linux. It's like this crappy fucking weird ass OS. And when I mean crappy, not that it's unsecure stable, it's just like, there's just a lot of fucking problems really compared to other OSs for the end consumer. Why the fuck should I use that when I can do everything I want on Linux and, not Linux, on Windows and Mac OS, and I already have it installed? I don't have to reinstall anything. It's just there, you know, and it works. It has some quirks, but it works. This is going to do nothing for the, as much as you want to sit here and give me like a 10 fucking thousand page rotation, the essay about why it's going to change, the best indicator of the future is the past. And I have close to 30 years of experience with this fucking shit. And I can tell you, it's not going to happen. Because all of those fucking essays that you're writing right now, they have been writing every fucking year, ever since this was a thing. And nothing has happened. Just like the Steam Deck. The Steam Deck was the console that would make Windows gaming obsolete. Everyone would move away from gaming on Windows when the Steam Deck came out. How's that going for you? Just asking. Because when I go on to YouTube, when I go on to Twitch, Kick, Dingleberry streaming platforms, 99% of all fucking gamers still use Windows. And most of them, if not all of them, or not all of them, but a lot of them are using Windows 11. Where is the Steam Deck will make Windows gaming obsolete? I wonder. Will there or can there be a distro, a device that will knock Windows out of its dominance? There could be made one of those. There's always a possibility that the perfect distro at the right time, or the perfect device at the right time, will knock Windows off its prominence. The chances are super fucking slim. Like, it's one of a million kind of chance. But every fucking collective Linux YouTuber thing that is like, oh, it's certainty, I am sure. And then they will make a lot of videos explaining why. And every fucking year, and the year after that, when it don't happen, they just quietly say nothing. How many content creators, Linux content creators, have you seen making videos about how end of life of this Windows is going to make everyone move over to Linux and blah, or you'll see a massive insurgence in Linux users using stuff like that? How many people have you seen 1-2 years after that saying, oh, that didn't happen. Zero. None of them made a video 1 or 2 years after something end of life happened and saying, oh, yeah, well, we didn't went from like 4% to like 10% overnight or over like 6 months. Yeah, it didn't happen. We didn't get, you know, how many Steam Deck is going to take a, make every gamer move to Linux, have made a video like how many fucking years after that they said that and say, oh, well, we were wrong. Zero. They just shut their mouth. They wait until the next thing comes around, the next kind of Steam Deck, or the now Steam OS on consoles, they, or the Steam console they are talking about. Or they're waiting for another end-of-life release of Windows, and then they do the exact same fucking year. This is the year! We are taking over the world! And then 2 years later, nothing has happened. They're just like, do anyone remember the video I made about, you know, Linux taking over the world? That didn't happen? No? No? Okay. It's not in my archive. Don't go look for it. It's not existing, isn't it? Let's talk about proprietary software patent, okay? They just forget about it until the next thing. And then they forget about it. And then it's YouTubers are the funniest people on earth. They're almost being comedians without actually being comedians. It just baffles me that such a simple thing is just looking at history and saying, like, okay, when Windows 8... and got end of life, or Windows 7 got end of life. Linux was really good back then. It was as good as it is today compared to how Windows is today. Like, it was so much, in quotes, better than Windows back then as Linux is better than Windows today. We just have better gaming a little bit. It didn't happen then, and Linux don't have any killer feature now that they didn't have then. Like I said, we have better gaming, but most people, they just stick with Windows for gaming. You've seen this over the years. Ever since we got better gaming on Linux, not a lot of people moved over to it. And you say, oh, but PewDiePie, he's one person. And who knows if he moved back to Windows or if it's just... we don't know what we saw. We don't know... he's not made like a public announcement saying that I am moving totally to Linux or something. It could just be him fucking experimenting to see what this Linux is about. We all have done that before, experimenting with a distribution or OS. Just because you install Arts or Gentoo, that don't mean that you forever and ever 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 again are going to run that distribution. It could just have been a fucking little experiment he did. Who knows? Calm your fucking tits. And again, this is... I hate to say it, but you just can't fucking take many Linux YouTubers seriously because they do stuff like this. I remember when NVIDIA open source part of their drivers many, many years ago now, like, was it in 2020 or something like that? It was like, this is going to revolutionize gaming. Everyone is going to game on Linux. Every fucking graphic card from NVIDIA is going to be better supported on the Linux. They were like fucking fuming out of their mouths of joy and blah, blah, blah. The only thing that happened is AI got better under Linux. That's it. The only reason why we have some games running better under Linux, and I mean some games, it's like the vast minority of, or the vast majority of games don't run better on Linux, but we have a few games that run better on Linux. That's not because NVIDIA open sourced their fucking NVIDIA drivers. It's because of Proton and the work that they're doing with that. That is a heavily sponsored, or a company heavily sponsored by a $1 billion company, by the way. That is... their whole business model is proprietary software and anti-consumerism, or anti-developer, and to some degree anti-consumerism, and having a monopoly, which is something you should not say because we cannot talk bad about Valve in Linux, around Linux. But that didn't do anything for gaming. Nada. But oh my god, like next, in a year or so, nobody's going to remember Windows. And yet here we are. Here we are, buddy. Most people gaming on Windows still. They will find some other excuses why that is. Again, it's super hard to take Linux content creator seriously. If you are worried about the end of life of Windows 10, the people that need to do something about it already know or have done something about it. So they know what to do or have already done it. The people that should not be worried about it don't even know that it's reaching end of life. And it don't impact their life a matter one fucking bit. They're not getting more insecure. Still getting security updates. Heck, they may even have to fucking update lesser than, you know, like do the whole Windows upgrade cycle, like rebooting and shit like that, lesser than they do nowadays. So for some people, that can be a blessing in disguise, so to speak. And a lot of people don't need the latest and greatest features. Heck, there will probably be a shit ton of AI irritations you don't have to deal with under Windows 10 because it's just not coming to Windows 10. So if you're one of those anti-AI people, this would be the perfect Linux distribution for you, or Linux release for you. Not Linux, Windows release for you. You're getting all of the capabilities and software support and hardware support of Windows without the AI bullshit. Or at least not all of the AI bullshit. I think Copilot is still supported on it and stuff like that. For people that don't want to deal with all that fucking shit but still need Windows. There you go, buddy. Yeah, it's actually not that big of a deal. But Linux YouTubers, they love to tell you it is. They love to, like, here's a guide to move, how to move to Linux from Windows 10. I've seen a lot of people making, like, here's a guide to move to Linux from Windows 7, and blah, 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 blah. Yeah, not going to happen. And that's the thing. A lot of the things that they would love to happen is not going to happen. Because here's the thing. If the majority of people really, really wanted Linux, they would be using Linux today. If consumers are stupid and not stupid at the same time. If a consumer base, a consumer group really, really wants something, they will get it. Even if that means that they have to fucking, you know, get it legally. Like, look at it for media consumptions. There's a lot of places in the world where they just can't see some movies or some TV series, but there's a lot of people that really, really want to. Well, there are ways of getting that shit. And they do it. There are places in the world where they can't get something because it's either too expensive or it's only sold in X, Y, and Z big cities. Either they get knockoffs or there are people that are acquiring it in alternative ways and then reselling it for lesser money in other places, in those places. The consumers always get what they want. That's one of the things a lot of people don't seem to understand, I guess. If the consumers really, really wanted Linux, if it was something that was really, really the best, that was really, really something that most people would benefit from, consumers would not be able to shut their fucking mouth. Bob will talk to Amy, that will talk to Josephine, that will talk to Christian around the fucking water cooler about Linux until everyone was running it. Like, look at like a popular TV show. When Game of Thrones was around, I didn't watch Game of Thrones while it was running. I don't like watching TV series while they're running. I wait till they're done, so I can watch all of it at once. But you still knew what the fuck was going on, because everyone could not stop fucking talking about it. And that's what consumerism is. If it's something they really, really want, they will not stop talking about it. If one person or 10 people saw Linux, they were like, holy fucking shit, this is the best thing since sliced bread. Word by mouth, tell everyone, and they will 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 be using Linux. That just don't happen. And then you're blaming Microsoft, proprietary companies. The consumer don't care. If they really, really want Linux, they will not stop talking about it. Anyway, I'm out of here. See you later. Bye-bye. Thank you.